American League Division Series. It's with my partner Chris Singleton. I'm John Shombe. Game one is always critical in a postseason series, Singy.
Yeah, and this is when you love having home field advantage, Boog. If you capture game one, you're full of confidence that you've got a chance to ride that momentum for the rest of the series.
And on the visiting side, starting pitching is always the big key in a game like this to kick off a series.
Yeah, you need a strong performance on the mound. That's the number one way to cancel out the home field edge we just mentioned.
All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. So, almost ready to get underway. And on the hill in this one, Gerrit Cole. Always a treat to watch one of the best starters in the sport, Singing.
Well, the big thing is that the way he holds his curveball, it's more of a knuckle curve. And because of that, it's less predictable in terms of the break for the hitter. That makes it that much harder to hit this guy.
Game one, and we are ready to go. Now the left fielder, number 38. Got him. One gone here.
Man, I really like the ability to bounce back right there after not getting a call. He probably should have gotten. He didn't let it affect his focus, and he came back with another good pitch to get him swinging.
And up next for Cleveland, Ahmed Rosario. Good contact guy, good defender. And the next pitch is way outside.
I love that Gerrit Cole is sort of a throwback guy out there on the mound, sort of that classic power pitcher. He's going to attack with that fastball, move it all around the edges of the zone, and when he has to, fill up the strike zone with confidence that hitters can't touch it.
Right-hander kicks, deals. Swing and a miss, struck him out, and two away now.
Well, anytime you can punch out the top two guys in a lineup to start an inning, got to be feeling pretty good out there on the mound, because when you think of just having a distraction, table setters on the base paths, and all of a sudden you're dealing with a number.
Well, he settles under it in left, and that will end the inning. Guardians fail to score, and now the Bombers will get their shot. No. Back in the Bronx, and today's starting pitcher, Shane Bieber. Lots of punch outs, a real strikeout artist, Singy.
Anytime you have five pitches to work with on the mound, that repertoire can be a real weapon in terms of keeping hitters off balance, man. It's one of those things that I'm going to be looking for in this one. Does he have a feel for all of those pitches, or is he just able to get one or two over in the strike zone where he wants? Now, it's tough to do to be able to command all those pitches, but if he can, he is going to be very tough for the opponent today.
The wind of the pitch. Judge rips that one. That's back. Turning, looking, and that one is gone. Aaron Judge leads the yard, and they jump out front. It's 1-0.
Hitters today are looking to pull the ball and get it in the air. Even on a breaking ball away, does a nice job of staying square to the plate, allowing his arms to get extended and get good wood to it.
And here is Anthony Rizzo. And a count 1-2.
With the big bats coming up and a home run already surrendered, he's really going to have to execute against these next couple of batters.
Here's a high fly ball out to center. Straw drops steps, heads back on it, makes the grab, tracks it down after the long run, and there's one away. Here is the young phenom, Gleyber Torres. One down, base is empty. And that one is lifted in the air. Lays out and makes the play. this dive wasn't the result of a bad route, Singy. The only reason he made the plays because his route was so good.
No doubt, Boog. StatCast tells the same story. I mean, he got to his spot as quickly as you can possibly get there, and he had to in order to have a chance at that diving play. Just special.
Now it's Josh Donaldson's turn to hit. On the ground to third. Toss to Naylor, and they take care of Donaldson for the out. Inning over. One scores in the inning, coming on this solo home run. It's now 1-0. Back at Yankee Stadium, here's Josh Naylor. Left-hand batter waits. And it is 2-1. In the air, left field, Hicks. Sizing this one up, makes the grab, one down. Here's Andrés Giménez. He's someone that you might not describe as having elite level speed, but he can absolutely move, and it is a factor in his game. And he walked him.
Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
One down, and stepping in is the speedy Oscar Gonzalez. Next offering is down low, and it's 2-1. Giménez, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. Cole checks to first, and he dives back in safely. The 2-1. Good eye right there.
This is one of those situations defensively where you can't try to do too much. You got to make sure that you field the ball cleanly and get one out first. It's going to be tough to get two with this kind of speed in the batter's box.
And ball four, two aboard.
Maybe a little loss of focus on the mound right there. Pretty much gifted him first base with a quick free pass.
Next to hit, Will Brennan. And a foul ball. One out. Runners at first and second. Downstairs, and it misses, ball four.
Well, the stage has been set for this offense, Boo. It's all about creating opportunities, and this is one of them right here.
Austin Hedges stands in.
He's looking for a ground ball to get a double play and out of this jam.
One out, base is full.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
And a swing and a miss. Huge strikeout there.
Well, this is where the team aspect really comes into play on the offensive side of the game, right? I mean, missed opportunity to tie it up with the runner at third, one out, couldn't put the ball in play. So now it's time to pick him up. And that's where good teams, they go to. They operate on this level of next man up. That mentality is what causes them to win series, get into the postseason. That helps keep the energy and morale high in the dugout.
Line drive, base hit. One runs in, two runs are in. Brennan headed for the plate. He's in there. Three-run score. And they take a two-run lead.
How about that? Clears the bases. Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. The ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it.
Swing and a miss. That is strike two. And a pitch. Line to second, snagged on the bounce. That's out number three. But three score in the inning, and they come on this bases clearing triple. It's now a 3-1 ball game. Welcome back, and now it's Giancarlo Stanton.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
The 1-2. That one missed. Giancarlo Stanton, certainly a physical presence, and Chris, one of the more imposing guys at the plate in the entire sport.
He's a force, and I think it's scary for pitchers thinking about making a mistake to him, because you know you're not going to get that baseball back. He hits the ball so hard, you don't even have to watch him swing. You can just close your eyes and listen and know exactly who it is that hit the ball.
Next offering upstairs.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
And a payoff pitch. Stays alive. The pitch. That one the other way. That's a base hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
Well, he really had to battle for that one. Man, that was so fun to watch. Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly. And you can feel this crowd waking up a bit here as the guys are starting to make some noise with their bats.
1-2 here. In the dirt. Now throw to first, but back easily. Stanton aboard here at first with nobody out. The next three offering ball, misses, and that's ball three. Next offering is foul back. The kick, the 3-2, and that's ball four.
Well, looking for a swing and miss right there, or for the ump to help him out and make the call with that last pitch, but neither happened. Close pitch, but a good take to earn that walk.
Isaiah Kiner-Falefa up to the plate. Turned on, but that's foul down the third baseline. He swings and fouls one off. And a pitch. Ground ball right side, could be two. Fires over to first. That's one out, the bottom of the second. Here's Jose Trevino. He's built his reputation as one of the top framers in the sport. One down, runners at second and third. On the ground, right side, and he handles it himself for the out. Now here's Aaron Hicks. Kicks and fires. And there's a ball.
Ball out there on the mound. He's got to go right after this hitter because you don't want to turn this lineup over. This is the guy that you've got to get that final out, get out of this inning.
Now front pulls that one foul. Now it's 3-2. Righty delivers, and that'll load the bases.
He knew he had a little wiggle room with the open base, but now that disappears. Mistake to this next batter, and this inning might really break open.
It's Aaron Judge now. And now it's 1-2. And a foul ball. He stays alive.
There, he can move the ball around, add and subtract, get some weak contact at times. So you don't worry as much about him in this situation. Very capable of getting a ground ball and getting out of this little jam.
Swing and a miss, and that is that.
Well, this guy competes hard. We see the emotion there. I love it. Great job of getting out of the jam.
Back for more from the Bronx. Top half of the third inning, and now it's Ahmed Rosario.
It's good speed at the top of the order here. You want to get it on, see if you can get a stolen base, maybe get around the bases and pick up a run.
On the ground. That's a hit. And the leadoff man aboard.
Well, patience and discipline paid off right there as he got into an advantage count. Just kept it simple. Played pepper with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from. And there's just no one there to knock it down. And now they've got some speed on first. So we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
Here's Jose Ramirez. Comes a 2-2. Stays alive. In the dirt. Nice job behind the plate there. Ninth pitch of the at-bat due next. And here it comes. Swing and a ball hammered left field. Way back there. Turning, looking, and that one is gone. Jose Ramirez bops one out, and they throw a pair on the board. It's 5-1.
That's the exact definition of hitting the ball where it's pitched, taking that outside fastball and driving it the opposite way out of the ballpark. You want to bottle that type of approach.
And now it's Josh Naylor. Left-hand hitter waits.
It can be tough to bounce back after a big home run, but nobody on, nobody out. You just have to treat it as a fresh inning.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Well, he looks fresh out there. Just needs to get a little more confidence and remember how good he's been in the past.
That one is absolutely belted. Banks off the wall. The throw in. Not going to get him. He's in there.
Drove that ball nicely, put a great swing on it, and it jumped off his bat. Kind of put it all together there, and he's rewarded with the double.
So digging in, Andrés Giménez. This guy has turned into a beast. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. And he deals. Swing and a pop-up in foul ground. And out number one on the grab. Oscar Gonzalez digs in for the Guardians. Next pitch misses. 2-1. At the belt and fires. Bounce to the left side. Donaldson tosses to first in time. And there are two outs. And now the right fielder, Will Brennan. Left field. Flashes the leather on the running catch. And that'll do it. Cleveland with a pair on this blast. It's now 5-1. Back now in the Bronx. Here's a big power threat. Anthony Rizzo. 2-1 now. In the air, left side. Number 38 settles underneath it. Makes the catch for the out. Here at New Yankee Stadium in the Bronx, and they have this new ballpark that is absolutely gorgeous, but there's still some of that old school feel to it. Next offering misses, and it's 2-1.
Yeah, you have to connect the past with the present, and they did a really nice job of the Monument Park out there where you can go and walk through and see the legends. This is New York, and it is the greatest city, I would say, in the country, if not the world. So you expect them to build a ballpark that's going to be incredibly rich in that tradition.
The 2-2. Swing, and this one's bounced to the ground. Toss to Naylor. Two up, two down. What about as a left-handed hitter and how short that porch is in right field? Were you ever tempted to just try and think in terms of leaning on something as a left-handed hitter and just trying to yank it over the right field wall?
I don't think I needed to be tempted to do that. I think that's all I was, you know, trying to do because I didn't have a whole lot of power.
Throw pulls him off the bag, and he's safe.
Looked to me like he got on the side of the ball a little too much right there, maybe a little too casual as well with the throwing motion. And when you don't stay on top of the ball and really get out front and finish with a good release point, it's very easy to lose control of it to either side.
Swing, and that ball smashed on a line. Brennan makes the catch, and that'll do it. The Yanks lead one. They're down 5-1. Back at Yankee Stadium, John Ciampi with Chris Singleton, and set to lead off the fourth, Austin Hedges. Next offering is in for a strike. 1-2 now. Ah, that hit him. And the leadoff man is aboard to start the inning.
Well, that definitely didn't come out of his hand the way that he was intending it to. And the release point was a little bit off as well.
Singing four homers in 22 games at Old Yankee Stadium. What do you remember?
Well, I remember my rookie.
Here comes the pitch. Runner breaks for second. And that one wrapped foul.
So I went into the game. I happened to hit two. When I walked into the store the next day, and he looked at me, said, "You're trying to put me out of business, aren't you?" And that was a great, great experience that I had as a rookie playing against the Yankees, playing in New York.
Cut on and miss. Struck him out. And there's one down.
Boog gets talked about a lot, but a good high fastball in a two-strike situation, it's just become such a problem for hitters in more recent years. But with all of the emphasis by pitchers on developing that spin rate, having a good grip on the baseball, those high fastballs, they kind of look like to the hitter that they're rising, even though they're not, but they're not decreasing in velocity and spin rate. So very difficult to get the barrel on it.
So first and second with one man gone, and the batter will be the shortstop, Ahmed Rosario. 3-2 now. Got him looking, and there's two away.
Just locked him up right there for the second out, and that's an at bat he's probably going to be thinking about for a little while. Didn't pull the trigger. Not how you want to go down in an RBI spot, so now you got to hope your teammate behind you can pick you up.
Next offering is in for a strike. So did Super Joe give you two suits?
Super Joe hooked me up with two suits.
Got him. And the inning is over. Guardian stranded. And welcome back. Bottom four. And stepping in for the Yankees, Oswaldo Cabrera. The 1-1 is upstairs. Two balls and a strike.
One strike.
The pitch. In for a strike. Two and two now.
Two balls, two strikes.
Got him swinging. He chased the changeup, and that's the first out.
He came out of his mechanics there. Typically, he likes to shoot the ball the other way, but that time, a little anxious.
Next offering finds the zone of the count is full.
Love how vocal the umpire is today. No doubt in the hitter's mind, catcher's mind, and even the pitcher's mind as to the conviction in the call. Well, he's normally going to fill up the strike zone and really limit base runners, but his command in this one just seems off out there. A lot more walks than he's used to giving up.
Then at first, Jose Trevino stepping in now for the Yankees. Bieber checks the runner. Connor Falefa back in standing. The punch out there. That's the second out. Now it's the switch hitting outfielder, Aaron Hicks. He reached on a walk his first time. Connor Falefa off of first with two away. Next pitch misses outside. The count now 2-2. And the right-hander deals. On the ground to the left. Oh, the throw is wild. Safe at first as they can't make the play. Aaron Judge at the plate. He's a guy who does it all. With the lack of contact in today's game, this guy hits for contact, so he delivers average, but there's on base and slugging too. So now 1-2.
Early in the count, you have to be real careful because of that power, but then if this hitter gets a strike or two on him, he's still very comfortable, and because he has the ability to get the barrel to the baseball, he's a threat deep into the count as well.
Two outs, couple of base runners at first and second. Ground ball up the middle. They take the force out, and that will end the inning. Yanks strand a pair. They're down here 5-1. Here at New Yankee Stadium in the Bronx, ready now for the fifth inning. And now the first baseman, Josh Naylor. And a 1-2. That's to third. Fires across the diamond, and the leadoff hitter retired in the fifth. So up next, Andrés Giménez. We talk about guys with good speed, and definitely he has it. But pushing the offense aside for just a second, Chris, it's the defensive side that I think the speed factors in the most. The count 2-1. In the air to left, down the line. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. Two down. And now it's going to be Oscar Gonzalez. This one in the air, center field. He's got it. And that is out number three. Guardians go down 1-2-3. They're up 5-1. We head to the bottom of the fifth, and here's the first baseman, Anthony Rizzo.
He is very much your typical power hitter. I'd say he falls into the three true outcomes category.
But we've seen more and more of that lately. The ability to drive the ball to slog is getting heavily favored over any discipline or strikeout concerns.
The pitch. Foul ball. They've got a potent lineup. And when you think about teams capable of rallying from this kind of deficit, they're right at the top of the list. The pitch. And that one fouled off.
Well, he hasn't gotten the result yet, but it's got to feel pretty confident. Three foul balls in a row. He's right on this guy.
For you growing up in New York City, I mean, you're a big sports fan. Tell me about your experience with the Yankees growing up.
I really went to Shea Stadium more than I did to Yankee Stadium. I grew up a Phillies fan. There was one game, though, that I went to as a kid. I sat in the upper deck. It was the game that Bo Jackson hit three homers in his first three plate appearances and then hurt his shoulder diving for Deion Sanders inside the park home run. That's probably the most memorable game that I ever attended as a fan at Old Yankee Stadium. Toss to Naylor. Home half of the fifth inning moving along. Two quick outs. Here's Josh Donaldson. Next offering upstairs.
Well, these guys have had a hard time scoring in this one. The guy out there on the mound wants to keep attacking, make sure that they don't get any confidence.
Out towards right center field, Brennan settles underneath it, makes the play, and it's out number three. Down in order, go the Yankees. They're down 5-1. Out of the bullpen for the Yankees, Clark Schmidt.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and he needs a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
Back in the Bronx. All right, we go to the top half of inning number six, and now Will Brennan. Here's a 1-1. On the ground, right side, collected by Torres. And that's one out as they get the leadoff hitter in the sixth. And now the catcher comes up to hit. Austin Hedges, he's 0-for-1. And a pitch. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. So Hedges is gone.
Thought it was a pretty good pitch. Top of the strike zone. We're seeing more fastballs in that location. Hitters, especially with two strikes, have to be ready to pull the trigger.
So two down now, and here is Miles Straw. The next pitch misses. Three balls and a strike. Fought off foul. Two outs. Swinging a foul back. That's out of play. The pitch. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And that's the third out. The Guardians go down in order. They lead this one, though, 5-1. Back here at the ballpark, bottom of the sixth. Giancarlo Stanton to the plate now. The Yanks in striking distance, but have some work to do.
Boog, it starts with the leadoff man. I need a good at bat out of him right here.
Swing and a miss. That's strike two. Cleveland has some action going in their pen. Aniel De Los Santos getting loose out there. Henches getting cranked up as well.
2-2.
The next offering misses. 3-2 now. Stanton, a guy capable of hitting it a long way.
Oh, you can tell how comfortable he is. Look at that front foot on the line as he is close to the plate. but he can be very quick to a pitch that is down and in.
On the ground to third, and that's just foul. He's a guy that's changed his stance over time. It's been a little more open, straight up, and now more closed.
One thing hitters will do, it's not so much about the stance, but it's what it does to the brain in terms of resetting and how they approach the pitcher.
You know, I think he's okay with that outcome. It wasn't an intentional walk, but he wasn't exactly trying to attack the zone either.
The 1-1. Nobody out. Runner at first.
He's pitching well, but not throwing a ton of first pitch strikes. Usually doesn't work out for success, but you can never predict baseball.
Two-two. To short, could be two. To Jimenez. On a nailer. They get two. And now, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa. Bounce to the right. Jimenez, throw to first. That takes care of Kiner-Falefa. Three up, three down, inning over. Back at Yankee Stadium, here's the left fielder, number 38. Here's a 1-1. Just missed. Bunt attempt, but that goes foul. A wide to kick the pitch. Fly ball to right. Puts it away for the out.
Maybe caught that one off the end just a little bit. Couldn't quite barrel it up enough to really drive it.
Ahmed Rosario digs in for the Guardians for the fourth time tonight. Next pitch is popped up. Trevino brings it in. That's out number two. Jose Ramirez stands in with two away as he takes a ball. Next offering is fouled back. Fouled off. He was late.
Well, he gave up on that pitch early and it ended up staying in the zone. I'm sure he's kicking himself and would like that pitch again.
Stays alive. Eighth pitch of the at bat coming up. That's hard hit on the line. And he makes the catch. And that is that. Nothing doing for the Guardians there. They're up 5-1. Aniel De Los Santos comes on now, and he'll work on holding this lead. And here's the catcher, Jose Trevino. The Yankees looking to rally. Next offering is foul back. Here comes a pitch. Swing and a pop-up. Naylor on his way over. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's one down.
That was a good pitch to hit right down the heart of the plate. Had pretty good timing on it. Just got underneath it a little bit and popped it up.
Here's Aaron Hicks. And the right-hander's 3-1. And there's a foul ball. Got him. Down on strikes, and he knew it.
Well, just couldn't pull the trigger on the fastball right there, and I don't think he was taking it, thinking it might be a called ball or anything. I just think he was flat out frozen. Did not expect that location, in my opinion.
The 1-1. And now 2-1 after that missed inside. Strike two. And that one in the air center field. That's a base hit. Joey gets on base and keeps it going. The tag, and that's out number three. Inning over. So here comes the big lefty, Aroldis Chapman, to the mound. And this guy can bring it velocity-wise. Now the four-hole hitter for the Guardians, Josh Naylor. In the air, out towards left center. Hicks racing over to make the catch. So in now for Cleveland, Andrés Giménez. Kicks and deals. That one's in there. And that is strike two. Activity in the bullpen for the Yankees. Miguel Castro preparing to come on if needed. Peralta warming up as well. The 1-2. And that just misses.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
Swing and a ball lifted left field. Drops into the glove. And there's two away. Now it's the DH, Oscar Gonzalez. Two down, nobody on. And that one fouled off. The pitch. Got him looking. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Guardians fail to score. They lead this one, though, 5-1. So Cleveland brings on a new reliever, Eli Morgan, trying to protect this lead. Ready for the bottom of the eighth. And stepping in for the Yankees, Anthony Rizzo. And the righty deals. Misses outside. And the count 2-1. The wind of the pitch. That misses. And that's ball three. The wind of the pitch. In there at the knees. Counts full 3-2. Right-hander kicks, deals. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him.
Well, when you commit to throwing an inside fastball to your glove side across the strike zone, especially with two strikes, if you're going to miss, you want to miss off the plate in. You do not want to leave it out over the heart of the plate. So that was excellent execution on that pitch. Really tied him up, and he couldn't get a piece at all.
The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Boo, do you think you could draw a walk in the bigs if we gave you enough at-bats?
Oh, that's a good question.
I think that if they gave the pitcher a false scouting report on me, yes, I think I could draw a walk. Swing and a ball hammered. Left field. That's back. Hauls it in on the warning track.
Every day during batting practice, these outfielders get about 10 minutes of balls in the gaps. They practice this, and when the game comes, they make the play perfectly.
The 1-1. And a foul ball, third base side.
Great swing and solid contact. Just a little too quick. He's got to stay back a little longer.
Next pitch is outside. Torres, the runner at first with two gone. On the ground, right side. Dives, and he can't hang on. The flip to the pitcher covering, and that is that. One left for the Miguel Castro into the game. And here is Will Brennan. Next pitch downstairs, ball two. Righty delivers. Swing and a bouncer. Throws to first. Now one gone in the ninth. Austin Hedges now. And the pitch. That catches the corner. Movement in the Yankees pen. Lou Trevino up and throwing. 1-2 now.
2 balls, 2 strikes.
Ground ball to the right side. Tosses to the pitcher covering the bag. Pitcher gets to the bag for the out.
Good sinker low in the zone right there and produced exactly what he was looking for. Ball on the ground. Nice ground out.
Miles Straw digs in for the Guardians. 1-for-3. And a pitch. And now 2 balls and a strike.
The count is 2-1.
And another ball.
The
count is 3-1. 3-1 is on the way. Oh, that got him on the mound. Safe at first, and an infield single keeps the inning going. Here's the Cleveland leadoff hitter, number 38. Right-handed reliever. Runner takes off. Pitch misses. Throw to second, and great jump.
Well, it really doesn't matter what the situation is. When a guy like this gets on first, you know he's going to steal second at some point during the at-bat. Nice job to get into scoring position. The defense probably knew it was coming, but they just couldn't do anything to stop it.
The 2-1. There's the strike. Is there a little wrinkle to that? I think there was.
Yeah. A little slider action.
And now 2-2. And now the count filled up 3-2. Up the middle, Torres handles, gathers, and throws to first. And that'll do it. 6-7-8 scheduled to start the bottom of the ninth. It's the back now as they hand the ball to a fresh arm to start the bottom of the ninth, Nick Sandlin. And he'll do his best to hang on to this lead. The 1-1. Swing and a miss, and he waves at that one.
Yeah, I don't think anyone's got good numbers swinging at pitches in that location.
Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. And one away. So the bullpen doing a nice job backing up the effort from their starter.
Yeah, we've seen some pretty excellent pitching out of this staff so far. I mean, they've come in ready to do their job and get outs. They've been pretty tough to get to in this one.
Next pitch is inside, and that's ball two. And he deals. Fouls one off, 2-2. And a pitch. Up the middle, and a base hit. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single. One gone, runner at first. Jose Trevino stepping in now for the Yankees. Pickoff throw, back standing. He's in there safely. The pitch. Foul ball there. The 1-2. And that's downstairs and outside. Two down. That's out to center field. Straw raging back towards the wall. Snags it on the run. Two away. It's Aaron Hicks now. And the right-hander deals. And 1-2.
From a pitcher's perspective, that's a beautiful splitter right there. As a hitter, you don't like it, but he's commanded his fastball, and out of that same tunnel, that splitter comes, and the bottom just falls out of it.
Swung on, belted. That one back there, gone.
Well, he really crushed that thing down the line, and everyone had to hold their breath until it clanked off the pole. And every time that happens, it just kind of feels like a trick shot or something. But really, it's just a stroke of luck that it stays fair long enough.
Here comes Emmanuel Clase out of the bullpen. He's into the game with the bases empty. Yeah, the hard-throwing righty trying to secure these outs against a potent Yankee lineup, and it starts with Aaron Judge. Bounced up the middle. Throw to first. Ball game. And the Guardians take game one on the road.
Well, this was a tightly played game. Got a little of everything. Some timely hitting. Runs on the board. Key pitching and defense in certain spots. Definitely a fun one to watch.
Here's one final look at the line score from this one, Chris.
It was a close two-run game, and a couple of key moments just really made the difference. Not much separates these two teams.